Before I was diagnosed with cancer, I was a pretty even keel person. I didn't really get anxious about much. I went through all of university with no test anxiety, nothing like that. And then I remember after I was diagnosed, when I was crying so frequently, and I went and saw my counselor, and I said, I don't know what's wrong with me. I never used to cry, but now I cry all the time. I'm so emotionally labile. And I was like, I don't know what's wrong. And he said to me, he's like, do you think maybe it's because you never had a reason to cry before? And that really hit home, because I didn't. I've been very fortunate. My life has been pretty easy up until this point. So for me, it was a huge adjustment learning how to deal with those emotions. And also, I had my frontal lobe played with during surgeries, which also affect your emotions and your ability to cope with certain things. So I've had to be really proactive, and I've worked on myself a lot the past year, because I didn't want to get into that crisis mode. The worst time I had was about 6 months ago, and I was having a few panic attacks during the week, and actually one of the hardest times was when I was doing my income tax, and I had to write out all my medical expenses and all the dates of all the appointments, and it was just flashbacks to, oh, this is the appointment where I found out I needed brain surgery, and this is the appointment where I found out that I needed chemo and radiation, and this is the appointment where I found out my prognosis of 3 to 5 years. And I had a complete panic attack and meltdown. So after that, and I was already doing counseling at that point, so my family doctor has been really good throughout this all. And every appointment I had with him, he would say, so how's your mental health? How are you doing? And for the longest time, I was saying, oh, I'm okay. I think I'm coping as well as anybody can. It's situational anxiety. It's not an everyday thing. But after that point, I finally decided, okay, I think I might need a little extra help. So I went on anxiety medication and depression medication just as an extra coping mechanism.